Today, we're going to talk about getting pregnant. Meet Mia and her partner, Alex. They are hoping to get pregnant. 8 out of 10 couples are able to get pregnant within the first year of trying. Here's how. Getting pregnant requires 2 people and 3 components: a working uterus, healthy sperm, and healthy eggs. The sperm must be able to fertilize the egg. And the egg must be able to settle down and grow in the uterus. In order to get pregnant, Mia and Alex must have unprotected vaginal sex around the time of ovulation. Ovulation is that time when the eggs are released from the ovaries. A quick way Mia can use to estimate the time of her ovulation: if she has regular periods, which are around 28 days from the first day of one cycle to the first day of the next, is to count 11 to 18 days from the first day of her last period. For instance, if her period started on January 1st, her ovulation will likely take place between January 11th and January 18th. Mia and Alex can plan to have unprotected sex every day or every other day during that week-long window. It is very unlikely that they will get pregnant right before or right after Mia's period, but for couples trying to avoid pregnancy, it's still a good idea to use protection during the entire month. Remember, condoms are the only birth control that protects against sexually transmitted diseases. What if Mia uses birth control? How long will it take her to be able to get pregnant after she stops? Mia should be able to get pregnant right after she stops using her pill, IUD, or implant. However, for some people, it may take up to 3 to 6 months to get a regular menstrual cycle back, which is an important part about getting pregnant. Another piece of good news is that using a hormonal birth control like the pill or IUD does not decrease Mia's chances of being able to get pregnant later on in her life. Now, what can Mia and Alex do to improve their chances of getting pregnant? As we talked about earlier, timing of sexual intercourse around the time of ovulation is helpful. There are many phone apps that can help keep track of Mia's period and ovulation, which both can be helpful to time intercourse. Both partners being healthy will also help maximize their fertility. Both Mia and Alex should do their best to stop smoking or using other tobacco products and stop using drugs and alcohol. It's especially important for Mia not to drink any alcohol or use tobacco products like cigarettes and vapes during pregnancy, since they can be harmful to a fetus. Both Mia and Alex should also try to maintain a healthy diet with lots of fruits and vegetables and exercise at least 30 minutes per day, 5 days a week. Walking counts. My last tip is that Mia should start taking a prenatal vitamin once a day. Since she could get pregnant at any time, it's important that her body has all the vitamins it needs to make a healthy baby. If you're considering pregnancy in the coming year, I encourage you to talk to your healthcare provider. What if Mia and Alex are not able to get pregnant within a year? They may be struggling with infertility, which we will discuss separately. We recognize that this video does not cover all possible situations, such as same-sex couples wishing to conceive, unintended pregnancy, and pregnancy using assisted reproductive technology. We hope to broaden the content covered on this channel over time, so stay tuned.